Hi, this is Lara at Elliott Wave Forex with your US dollar index Elliott Wave analysis for the New York trading session dated Tuesday, 29th of June. I'm going to start this analysis with an historical look just back for the last 3 years. We had a five waves down for primary C, five waves up for primary 1, an expanded flat correction A, B, C for primary wave 2. Expanded flats have B waves that reach beyond the start of A, and an A wave that breaks down to a three-wave structure. Usually the C wave is significantly longer than wave A, and it certainly is in this instance. We're now in a primary third wave to the upside, probably having only had intermediate 1, 2, and this chart's a little bit old, 3 and 4 also over, and we're 3 over, and working on wave 4 down to the downside. I'll take you to a more recent chart just for the last year here, where we're going to look at the daily chart with where this black 1 and 2 is this black 1 and 2 here. And here's our recent dollar rises with 5 waves up for 1, ABC for 2, 5 waves up for 3, working on ABC down for 4. Looks like this is going to be quite a deep correction, and it could get fairly close to 82.2. We've had a good strong 5-wave impulse down for wave A blue. We're working on an exaggerated 3-wave structure now for B blue, which is almost over. One more tiny little push up to go. And when that's over, we're going to have some good strong downwards movement. It's likely that wave C blue could reach equality with A, which could take the dollar quite close to this invalidation point, possibly around this fourth wave of 2 lesser degrees, possibly. That would be an interesting thing to look out for. Taking you now to an hourly chart for the last 20 days, where this blue A and blue B is here, blue A down here, B up here. Here's our good long 5-wave impulse down for wave A blue. Easiest to see this piece of movement as a 5-wave impulse, and as B looks like it's unlikely to retrace 90%, we don't need to try and see A as a 3-wave structure because this is not a flat correction. We've got a 5 waves up here for A, a 3 waves ABC down for B, and we're working on now a 5 waves up for C pink to end B blue. At this point in the very short term, we have an invalidation point to the downside here. While this fourth wave is completing, we don't expect price to move down to 85.78. When this fourth wave is over, and it could have been over at this point, it may have just turned, we should be seeing some strong upwards movement for the dollar. Not that far, not that much. Our target zone's not that far away, 86.45 to 86.54. So somewhere around this target zone, it's going to end its upwards movement for the short term. That's where A and C are going to reach equality, a pretty common relationship between the two. It's also where this fifth wave at green degree is going to reach equality with wave 1. And because this third wave is almost exactly 1.236 the length of wave 1, a great Fibonacci ratio there, I'm pretty confident that wave 5 is likely to reach equality here. So that's how I've worked out this little target zone. When it's finished this little piece of upwards movement, we're going to have a trend change for the dollar for some good, long, strong downwards movement. At that stage, I remove this invalidation point and recalculate it. The downwards movement that's coming after this is finished is probably going to look something like this. It's going to be a long, strong 5 waves down. It may not be this long, it may be just 0.618 this length, but it certainly could reach equality and not invalidate the wave count, so that is entirely possible. Pretty good idea of what to expect for the dollar for the next couple of days. If you don't find a video on YouTube of dollar analysis, I may very well have posted it on my site, just not done a video. So you may find charts and text analysis on my site. So check that out. I do that more regularly. That's all for me with your dollar analysis. I hope this is helpful in your trading, and I hope everyone's having an awesome time out there.